Right, very good afternoon to all. So I am from India, but working in Malaysia. Formerly, I was working in the government of Tamil Nadu, Forensic Science Department, for more than 2 decades. So many of them they know, just for the newcomers. And the currently working as an academician in Malaysia for about 2 decades. So here I am doing a lot of research in the forensic science. So this is the main idea of the presentation is to support our e-conference under Dr. Ranjit. That's what I am presenting here. So this is the recently I finished my research work. So normally this is related to the body weight determination from the 2D foot impressions. Normally the footprint, as already we told you this one, in many investigators, they simply ignore or neglected the evidence in the crime scene, because since I was in the crime scene for many years, so whenever they see any footprint, they simply ignore, it's of no use, something like that, right? Then after that, in some of the murder crime scene where there is no evidence except blood stained footprint, that because I was a declared footprint expert in India, in Tamil Nadu, so what I did was I used to collect the footprint evidence. Then for that we have no record. We need the suspect. So if it is again, we have to ask the police officers or the inspectors, whoever it may be, right? So now what they do is we have to get the suspect. Some of the officers, they are intensely sent for the namesake. They just 100, 200, something like that. But in spite of that, I collected their footprint evidence and come back and finally fixed the accused. So then after that, only the police officers, they impress the footprint work. Right. So in Malaysia also the same thing. When I come to Malaysia in 2003, here also they have no idea about the footprints, right? Even the syllabus also, we have the shoe print, something like that, there is no footprint at all. So that's why I started doing the research in Malaysia. I am doing a lot of publications here. So this is my recent research work in collaboration with the Philippine police. So normally I used to give talk to related to the footprint work in many countries. So this is a collaborative with this one, right? So normally already the crime scene, this is the starting point. So for laboratories, second one, the first, whatever the evidence were collected in the crime scene, that only it's proof for the fixing the accused, right? So normally even though the best equipped laboratory become useless, suppose instead of collecting a blood stain evidence, if you are collecting something mean, there is no use of the whatever the instrument or the costly or latest technology equipment, it's of no use. So the only thing is we have to find out the evidence, the appropriate evidence properly collected, and then send to the forensic examiner, then it's of use. So normally the evidence, normally the forensic investigator searching for the physical evidences, we have a lot of, I cannot limit the evidence. These are all the evidence only, lot. So these are all some of the evidences found in the crime scene, starting from the footprint, fingerprint, something like that. And the investigator, they are very happy with the fingerprint because we have the automated fingerprint analysis system. So many things are there. But whereas for the footprints, there is no the database or something like that. But now they understand the importance of footprint. Now they, in some of the countries, what they do is they record the footprint. Because the reason is the footprint give more information than the fingerprint. Suppose in a real crime scene, if you see this one, we can say a number of persons involved, whether it is a male or female, many informations they are giving this one. Now the researcher, they are starting their research in the footprint, right? So normally the footprint, we have the two-dimensional as well as a three-dimensional. Two-dimensional means you can see here. So whenever you walk on the murder crime scene, walk on the blood stain, mean you are leaving blood stain footprint, that is the 2D print on the hard surfaces. We have the measure the length and breadth, whereas in the soft surfaces, you can have the three-dimensional footprint. So three-dimensional, we can correct it through the casting, right? So this is my objective of this research is to develop regression equation to determine the body weight through 2D footprint anthropometry in a Tagala population, because this is a population specific. Because we cannot collect the footprints of Philippines. Philippines, there are multi-ethnic groups are there. So the regression equation is a population specific. So if it is a Tagala, this is one of the populations in Philippines. So I have collected the samples from them, right? So these are the Tagala family members here, because I visited the Philippines. So for the research, I visited the Philippines, they collected the footprint sample. So by see, there also, they appear it's very new to them. What is the footprint use or something like that? Then it come to the notice of the police. Then they say, "Sir, Professor, we come to give you a talk to our police officer." So in Philippines, they are the police officer doing the crime scene work. They are called the SOCO, scene of crime officers, right? So all are youngsters. Then they have given talk about the importance of footprints, something like that. Then they started learning the importance of footprints or something like that. So I have visited the Philippines and collected the footprint sample. So this one, this is the way in which are collecting the sample, 100 male, 100 female, right? Using the inking technique, right? I conducted many publications in the footprint. Using the inking technique, I collected the footprint. Then I have taken 10 measurements per individual, 5 measurements from the left side and 5 from the right side. So from this, I developed a regression equation based on the SPFS software, right? I developed the equation. So these are some of the information about this one, living body weight, right? And this is the footprint length for female. It is from 10 year at the end to the anterior end of the toes, from 5 toes, 5 length, similarly right and left, total 10 toes. So there are what I did was another, I take a combined samples. Combined samples mean I have combined the female footprints and male footprints. So now it become combined mean, we do not know whether it is a male or female, because in real crime scenarios, we can find the footprint, right? But we cannot say which is whether it's a male or female. So if it is so, the combined sample mean, I had derived a regression equation for this one. So if it is unknown mean, they can apply this formula so that they can the find out the approximate. It is not accurate the body weight. It is an approximate, right? It is something a range. So likewise, I suppose if the suspect is male mean, they can make use of this formula. If it is female mean, they can make use of this the regression equation derived for the male. Similarly, combined means unknown, right? So this is how I developed the regression. So this is the regression equation for this one, right? Right, so this one regarding the discussion, I already told you, the Michael Lindbergh, he told that footprint give more information than fingerprints of this one, right? And here I had developed the 10 equations, right? So even if it is a partial footprint, sometimes we can get the full print. Sometimes we are getting the partial mean. Even the presence of partial print, we can use one of the formula you can this one. And again, it is a population specific. So suppose if you are collecting for a particular population mean, this cannot be applied for any other population in the world. So that is the basic things about this one. So right. So from the based on this research, I have developed a regression equation to estimate living body weight from footprint length of the Tagalog populations in the Philippines, right? So these are all the some of my references. I conducted a lot of research in the footprint, right? And this one in a real crime scenario. So these are the things I collected footprints in Tamil Nadu. I was working in the Minimiri district. So there I am the in charge of this particular district. Mean for any crime, actually the police office, they rejected. They say, "No, sir, no use. This of no use." Still, in spite of that, I used to collect the footprint, the crime scene. So this is a three-dimensional footprint, right? So we can see in the public, they are all watching what I am doing or something like that. Then after that, they brought some suspect. It is tallied with this one, right? So this is the another crime scene. A woman largely complained that his husband was murdered and the body was found in this one. She said that, "Sir, when I opened the door, my husband was found dead. Immediately I come to the police station," something like that. So then I came to the crime scene. I asked her, "Did you enter to this place?" "No, no, no, I did not enter, sir. I just opened the door, he found dead. Come to the police station." Then after that, when entered the zone, so this is what is called the gate pattern. Just now they told you about the gate pattern, series of footprints, this one. Through the experience, when I examined this one, I found the footprints are very smaller one. So I suspected this maybe a female or something like that. Then I just inquired the background of this family member, right? Then after that, I collected the footprint of this complainant, the woman. And also when I see this one, I found the traces of some brownish stain in one of the toe. Then I conducted a test, BNT test. So in this part test, I conducted this one, it gave a positive reaction to the blood. So it is confirmed this one. Then after that, I told the inspector, so accused is nobody but this woman. Wife is the accused, but she is the complainant, right? Then she was taken to the police station and finally she confessed. So then as an expert witness, I was called in the court. I gave my evidence before the judge. The judge convinced. So based on this evidence, the case was convicted, right? So based on this one, this is a Malaysia University. I am teaching how to record the footprints to the my Malaysian student. Normally in Malaysia, there are three major races, Malay, Chinese, and Indians. Malay means Muslims, right? And the Chinese and also Indians, they are all three races in Malaysia. So there also, I've been teaching the importance of footprint, how far it is used to the crime scene investigation. So likewise, many of my students currently working as a police officers, forensic lecturers, private crime scene investigator. Now they are applying the importance of footprint. Whenever they are seeing any footprint in the crime scene, they just do the work and they do the comparison. Sometimes they are asking me, they call me, sir, I have some doubts or something like that. Then they come, they bring the footprint with me. Then I do the analysis or something like that. So likewise, now it is in the Malaysian student, current police officer, they are using this one. So this one, the current university, Management Science University, there also I'm teaching how to record the footprints or gait pattern, how the individual characteristics of the footprint, I'm doing this one, right? And the same thing, when I come to the, after I come to Malaysia, after a long time, I met one commissioner of police, right? He's the IGA police there at that time. Formerly, he was my SP. So one day he saw my publication. Then he asked me, Naraja, you give a talk to a police officer, what you are doing in Malaysia, something like that. So there, I am discussing about this one, the importance of footprint or something like that. Then he told that all the officers, you have to, whenever any footprint there, immediately you can call for the forensic expert, because in each and every district, one mobile forensic unit is there. So a forensic officer is there. So likewise, he just instructed the subordinates. And this one, I already told you, in Malaysia also, there is no awareness about the footprint, right? So when I talk with one of the police officer, he asked about the footprint. You are doing footprint research. What is the use of footprint? Something like that. Then I told my crime scene experience and how I solved the crime. Then they asked me, why can't you give you a talk to a police officer, Malaysian police officer? So likewise, also there also the I have given talk about the foot impression, importance of footprint. Now it is Malaysia also, now they started doing this work, right? And similarly, I was invited in the Naif Arab University of Security in Saudi Arabia. So there they have the College of Forensic Sciences. So they one day they invited me. You give a talk about the footprint to our Arabian student, something like that. Then I conducted a research also. I have a collaborative research in Saudi Arabia. This is the Philippines, right? Actually, this is the Philippines also. I went there. Earlier, one of the police officers, he just saw my publication. Then he called me. So I visited there. Then I started a sample collection there for the some collaborative research or something like that, right? So there they are called the SOCO, scene of crime officer. All are youngsters, right? Actually, there is a forensic lab unit is there, but very small unit. Then they told that in Philippines, forensics not well developed like in India. We will feature even develop the forensic unit. If anything, we will call you. You please guide us or something like that. So accordingly, now the Philippine police also, now they know the importance of footprint for crime scene applications. So this is one in Malaysia, they organize the Asian Police Forensic Network. There is a meeting every year. They conduct the Asian police, they meet together. So in 2 or 3 years before, they conducted this the meeting in Kuala Lumpur. So the chief police officer, they called me, Professor, on behalf of Malaysia, you have to represent and you give a talk about this one. So there also on behalf of the Malaysia, I have talked about the importance of crimes investigation. Why the neglected physical evidence in the crime scene, many evidence they are neglecting. Suppose if you are having any fiber or any tire mark, anything like that, just simply incur no use, something like that. So that's what I give the neglected evidence in the crime scene investigation. So one of the neglected evidence is footprint. So likewise, I give and talk to them. So many police officers, they ask so many questions because many police officers from Singapore, Thailand, Philippines, Brunei, all are senior police officers. They are all above 55 years old, senior officer, they attended the meeting. Then for whatever the doubt they are asking, I clarify, then they are impressed, right? So the last 3 days before, just 3 days before my university, they invited me, they give two awards for my contribution in research in forensic science in 2021. I was very happy, just sharing my happiness with you. 3 days before they awarded this one, two certificate for my contribution in research in forensic science. So this is my, I am thankful to my president, Management and Science University, and thankful to our Vice Chancellor, Dr. Junaina Vartili, sir. Thanks a lot. Thank you very much for Ranjit, for giving this opportunity to share my experience in this forum. Thank you very much.